Namo Education. If not yet subscribe, please subscribe and click the bell icon. So in this session, we are going to discuss our third question. In a right angle triangle ABC with right angle at B. So let's take it right angle at B. So this is right angle 90 degrees at B. They are telling this is the 90 degrees at B, in which A is equals to 24 units. So let's take this is the right angle triangle ABC. A is equals to what they are telling here is 24. So small a is nothing but the opposite side to the angle A. So this is what small a. So that will be equal to 24 units. Let's take 24 units or centimeters. Then small b will be for this opposite side small b. For this opposite side is small c. So small b will be equal to 25 units. And angle BAC is equal to theta. So what they are telling here is angle BAC equal to theta. So this is the angle. So this angle, they are telling that theta. Let's take. So what we need to take it here is this angle is theta. Then find the cos theta and tan theta. So in order to find the cos theta, for this cos means adjacent side is this one, then opposite side. So for this we need to find the all three sides. So what you can say here is from Pythagoras theorem, what you can write it here is Pythagoras theorem, what you can write, the hypotenuse square will be equal to sum of the squares of the remaining two sides. So that will be Pythagoras theorem. So that is, that will be hypotenuse is AC square, that will be equal to AB square plus BC square. So this is the hypotenuse. So we can take it, this is the hypotenuse. AC is equals to hypotenuse, capital H. H is nothing but hypotenuse. Then what is that AC? So we need to find it AB. So AB will be equal to AB square will be equal to AC square minus BC square. Then AB will be equal to square root of AC square minus BC square. So let's going to substitute the values here. Then AB will be equal to what you can say square root of AC square is what? AC is nothing but 25 square. Then BC is nothing but 24 square. Then what you can write it here is square root of 25 square is what? 625. So as we know, then 24 square is what? 576. So square root of 625 minus 576. What is that value? 625. Again, 49 we will get. So that will be equal to 7 square whole square. So here square and square root will going to cancel. This one, then 7 units. So what is this value here is 7 units. So what is cos theta? So we need to find the cos theta. Then cos theta will be equal to cosine theta. Cos, or you can say cosine. So this is cosine theta will be equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So for angle A adjacent side, we have to consider angle A. So for angle A adjacent side, so what you can write, adjacent side by hypotenuse. So we are taking hypotenuse as capital H. Adjacent side is AB, then hypotenuse is AC. So AB is 7, then AC will be 25. So this is the cosine theta. Then what is the tan theta? So tan theta will be equal to what you can write, opposite side by adjacent side. So for theta, opposite side is what? BC. Then adjacent side is AB. So BC is nothing but 24, then AB will be is nothing but 7. So this is the tan theta. We can find it another angle also, another function. What is that? Sine theta. So let's going to find sine theta will be, for this opposite side by, for angle theta, opposite side by hypotenuse. So what is the opposite side here? BC. Then hypotenuse is AC. So BC is nothing but 24, hypotenuse is 25. So from this you can calculate tan theta also. So tan theta will be equal to sine theta by, we are going to check it, is that cosine theta. So sine theta is nothing but what is that? 24 by 25. Then cosine theta will be equal to 7 by 25. So both will going to cancel, then we will get it as 24 by 7. So like this we have to find it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and please try to share with your friends and family members.